Hi, and welcome to another episode of DR News. I'm Stephen Perry, filling in for Ryan Johnson, who broke his ankle in gym class. For our feature story, Sadie talks with some student government members about their Thanksgiving basket drive. Sadie?
Hi, thanks, Steve. I'm Sadie Case, reporting for DR News. Right now, I'm at a student government meeting here in the Media Center. Soon, Erica Field, student government president, will explain to student government members about the Thanksgiving basket drive. Let's listen and find out what she has to say.
Okay, next week is the basket drive for Thanksgiving, and what we're going to do is in homerooms in the morning, you're going to collect money from just any students in the school, and we're going to use it to help needy families in Dighton or Hoboth. We're going to make them baskets for Thanksgiving. We're going to need volunteers to buy the food, make and deliver the baskets, and that will be the weekend before Thanksgiving. One thing about this is that the contest is for Spirit Week points, and every dollar is assigned a point value for each class. The seniors receive the least amount of points per dollar because seniors tend to make more money, and the freshmen receive the most. Besides that, it's pretty much as it's been in the past few years.
How do you plan to help out with the Thanksgiving basket drive?
Well, I'm going to do the shopping for the food and help make the baskets and deliver them. But a lot of other people are going to be going around homerooms, collecting the money, and a lot of other people help shop and deliver them also. So I'm just going to go shopping.
Wow, that's great that you're doing something to help out the community. Erica, how has the Thanksgiving basket drive worked out in the past years?
Well, my sophomore year, I worked on the basket drive, and I went to the Council on Aging in Rehoboth, and we actually bought the food and made it, which gives you an inner sense of that you're actually doing something for the community, so you really feel a lot better about it. And then we actually got to deliver the baskets to the people who need it. And you get to see how much they really appreciate it, and, you know, at the same time, you're getting points for Spirit Week, and everybody's into the competition, but you're also really helping people in your community, so it really makes you feel good.
Do you give the baskets to old people or poor people? I mean...
Well, it's usually, a lot of them are actually about the age of high school parents, and you don't really realize, some are elderly, and it's just pretty much people who need it. It doesn't really have an age limit on it.
Wow. Well, as you can see, the students are trying to help make Thanksgiving a special day for some people that are less fortunate. So have some holiday spirit and donate some money to the student government. Back to you, Steve.
Have you noticed the new concession stand at the football field? After years of operating out of an old trailer, Mr. Murray and his DECA students now have a brand new concession stand thanks to some concerned citizens and the vocational students here at DR. Dr. Richard Mello donated all of the cinder blocks for the walls of the buildings. Dr. Mello is a former member of our school committee. He also found a crew of volunteers who built the walls. The students in Mr. Colby's mill carpentry class made all of the counters for the interior of the concession stand. By the way, the guys down from mill carpentry also made cabinets and counters for us here at the Falcon Studio, so we know they do great work. Mr. Bramwell's structural carpentry class designed and completed all the rest of the work. These students spend part of every school day working on projects for the community. We know there's a waiting list for projects that they tackle, so we're lucky that they could squeeze this one in. So if you're at a home football game, check out the great work that these guys do. Now let's go to Jesse and see what's happening in the sports. Jesse?
Thanks, Steve. Hey, sports fans, welcome to another week of sports on DR News. The season's coming to an end, and our athletes have played well. Be proud of them, and look forward to seeing them in later seasons. This week I put together a special double feature, first with volleyball and wrapping up with golf. The volleyball players have played hard, making power serves and saves under extreme pressure. Now, let's go to the interview.
Hi, I'm Jesse Souza, and I'm here with key members of the 1994 volleyball team. Julie, how do you qualify for the state tournament?
To qualify for the state tournament, you have to finish the season with a record of at least 500, and then depending on your record, it is how you get seeded.
I see. Jill, do you girls do as well as you had expected to this year?
We were doing really good at the beginning of the season, but we lost a couple of players, so we went down in a little slump and we had some losses, but once they came back, we really picked up our game and started playing well again, so we did.
That's good. And Becca, are you girls losing a lot of seniors this year?
Well, we're losing 3 seniors this year, but they're key seniors. We'll use Lauren and I, our defensive players, and Amy's our setter.
Great. Thanks for your time. If you haven't seen a volleyball game, they just started the tournament games, and hopefully they'll do good. Sports games are a lot of fun to watch, and you'll have a chance to support your teams, so don't miss out.
After finishing second to Opponequit in both the regular season and in the South Coast Conference League tournament, the golf team finished its season with a bang. First, the team qualified for the Eastern Massachusetts Division II Championship by finishing second in a field of 15 teams on October 24th. Then, on October 31st, the team finished second in the Eastern Mass Finals, played at the very difficult Ipswich Country Club. The 6 players who represented DR in the tournament were senior captain and 3-time SEC All-Star Kevin Torres, junior captain and SEC All-Star Mike Graisley, sophomore Sean Cronin, juniors Jared Dyer and Matt Collins, and freshman Dan Lockhart, whose steady play played a major role in the Falcons' postseason success. With 5 players returning from this year's state tournament team, the future certainly looks bright for DR Golf. Congratulations to the golf team and to Coach Cute for a job well done. The trophies won by the team are on display in the trophy case near the media center. Well, I hope you enjoyed this week's special on sports. And one last thing, our former sports reporter, Brendan Green, is no longer able to be with us. He was forced to drop the class due to make up the work he missed. But thanks, Brendan, for all the help. We appreciate it. That's it for this week. Thanks for watching. Back to you, Steve.
Thanks, Jesse. I've seen those trophies, and they're pretty nice. Now let's go to Donovan and see what's happening in the corner.
Hi, and welcome to a special home ec edition of Donovan's DR Corner. I'm here outside the home economics room, and I'm sporting my apron, and I'm ready to get started to learn about what they do down here. So come on in, let's go. I'm here with Mrs. Skitt, and I'm going to ask her a few questions. She's the teacher of the home ec class. How are you doing today?
Fine.
Good.
How are you?
Good. Not too bad.
Good.
And I want to ask you, where do you get your food from? Is it donated, or do you have to go and pick it up yourself?
The school department has a charge account at a local supermarket, and I have a card, and I go in and make the selections of the food that I know we're going to be using and sign my name, and the bills are submitted to the superintendent's office.
And he takes care of the rest from there?
Right. I just have to haul it into school,
right.
But I don't pay for it myself.
Oh, well, that's a good deal. And what types of things do you prepare here in class?
We try to do a wide variety of things. Basically, we're a nutrition information program and try and teach the students how to eat well and make good decisions for themselves. We try and emphasize the new food pyramid guidelines and try and encourage them to eat high carbohydrate foods, a lot of fruits and vegetables, and to limit their intake of fat and salt, that kind of thing. So.
And what other things do you do in home ec class besides the cooking part of it?
Well, a couple of days a week we sit at the tables and have theory, and that's where they learn what it is, you know, it's all about. We have some, you know, they take notes and they have tests and we do worksheets and different kinds of activities to learn. And then they have a demonstration sometimes of what they're going to be preparing, so that's part of the learning process.
I see. So it's not only the class aspect of it, but it's more of hands-on as well?
Exactly. Like, the laboratory experience is really important because they enjoy it, and I think it makes the learning stick.
Yeah. Well, I want to thank you for your time.
You're welcome.
And
enjoy.
Have fun. Okay, thank you. So what other types of things do you make in this class?
We make omelets, pancakes, French toast, stuff like that.
And do you get to eat everything that you make?
Oh, yeah. It's great.
And is it good, even though that you made it? Is it still...
Yeah.
Decent?
Yeah, it's good.
Okay. And as you can see, we see our man John Barboza working hard at work over here. John, what are you working on right now?
Making pretzels.
You're making pretzels?
Yep.
And do you plan on eating these pretzels after you're done making them?
Yep, of course.
Are you sure they're going to be edible?
I hope so.
All right.
I'll give you some.
All right. Keep up the good work, John. I hope you enjoy my little episode here in the home ec room, and I hope you learned that they don't only cook, but they learn here as well. And they're being prepared for life after high school when they go to college, and they're able to cook for themselves, and they won't starve. So that's all I have time for this week, and I'll see you next week back in the studio. Back to you, Steve.
Thanks, Donovan. On one final note, if you have any suggestions for DR News, there's a suggestion box located right outside the studio. So from all the crew members here at the Falcon Studio, see you next week.
There's something wrong with the world today. I don't know what it is. Something's wrong with our eyes.